Vaccine passports, a ticket to a life of foreign travel, nightlife and leisure, or a path to social exclusion. Governments and developers around the world are exploring whether vaccine passports, to identify those inoculated against the coronavirus, could help to reopen their economies. But those developing the technologies are urging lawmakers to think seriously about overcoming the obstacles to their use. Biometrics company iProve, together with cybersecurity firm Mvine, received UK government funding to develop a vaccine pass that is now being tested within Britain's National Health Service. Andrew Budd is iProve's founder and chief executive.
I think there are huge issues. I mean, there are issues of discrimination, there are issues of two classes, there are issues of privilege, there are ageist issues, because it's likely older people, such as myself, will get the vaccines before younger people, which means that older people will have access to services and capabilities that young people are excluded from.
Here in Manchester, Northern England, some 420,000 people are employed in the nighttime economy. Event organisers say that while socially distanced concerts and events have kept people in work, they aren't financially viable in the long run. Sasha Lord is co-founder of the city's Parklife Music Festival. He says swiftly checking someone's level of protection would be a game changer.
You know, a gig isn't a gig, or a festival is not a festival unless you stood shoulder to shoulder with your friends, you're on the dance floor, you can't create the atmosphere. So those social distance gigs, they served a purpose, they kept people in jobs, but we have to look to get to back to normal.
iProve's Bud points out that vaccine certificates are being rolled out in some countries. And in the United States, private sector health passes have been used to admit people to sports events. It's the developer's job to work out the technicalities, he says. Conversations about the political and social issues can't wait.
This is going to happen. And the question is, how should it be regulated? How should it be regulated? What limits should be placed on it? What are the boundaries of social acceptability? I think those are real questions for civil society and for the government.